Hello, and welcome back to more LEGO Star Wars Complete Saga, where in the last episode we played through the 5th chapter of Attack of the Clones, which was Gunship Cavalry, and in this episode we're going to be playing through the 6th chapter of Attack of the Clones, which is Count Dooku. Let's do it. Episode 2, Attack of the Clones. Chapter 6, Count Dooku. As the battle rages between the clone forces of the Republic and the Separatist droid army, the Separatist leader Count Dooku flees to his secret hangar. Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker follow closely behind, prepared for a final showdown with the Sith Lord. I apologize, words are hard. Okay, first things first, True Jedi for this level is 22,000 studs. Second thing is that the first minikit's right there. You're supposed to float out to it with someone like R2-D2. But I got a better idea. That was not the better idea. The better idea is you jump out to it, and you die in the process. We haven't gotten any studs up until this point, so it doesn't really matter, because we have nothing to lose. So you may as well just jump out to it and get it now. Anyway, after you do that, head inside the building. Oh, wait, I almost forgot. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Back out. Okay. I forgot to sync this before I started recording. Anyway. True Jedi, 220,000, as I said previously. However, don't get too excited just because you have the score times 10 multiplier, because there still are not that many studs available to you in story mode. It's easier to get it in free play, even with the score times 10 multiplier, so I'm going to try to get it, no guarantees, but we'll try anyway. Next minikit, move these two things in front of the rock wall and then destroy them to get your hands on the second minikit, which we can acquire. Oh, never mind. Oh, Okay, never mind. It's only 10. Never mind. My memory is wrong. It was 10,000, not 20,000. Not 20,000. Okay. Never mind. It's super easy to get. Okay, first thing first, grab the power up and then just do a saber strike to take out all these guys at once. I missed one. Don't worry. We'll clean that up right now. If you can stand still, please. Thank you very much. And head over to the left side of the area so that we can get our hands on the next mini kit. And we're going to do stand on the bottom button, and then your partner will automatically jump up those ledges to get step on the second button, unless you're playing co-op, in which case that your second player are going to have to do it for you. Then jump up to grab this minikit right here. Now we can focus on getting out of the area by heading to the right side, stepping on the button, and you're allowing your partner to automatically jump up to the ledge above you. Have him stand on the button. Then you can do the same thing to the next button. You see where this is going. And he jumps up to the next button, and then at that point, you are clear to jump over to the final ledge. And both of you can use your force abilities on these two levers to open the door forward and go face off against Count Dooku. Let's drop down and head on over. Alright, first things first, you want to attack him 3 times. After you do that, he is going to retreat to the back end of the area, like so. Then what you want to do is you want to go over to this side and grab this power-up right here. There are no more minikits which we can obtain, but we can't get this power-up. Then head to the front side of the area once again as to where he is hiding. He's going to force some stuff at you like Darth Maul did at the end of the Phantom Menace. And we're just going to use the same tactic we did the last time on him here. He's going to force something at you. I failed miserably. And then we're just going to reverse force back onto him. Very simple. And then after you do this 3 times, Count Dooku will have had enough, and we will go into cutscene mode. Now we are in control of the Sith Master Yoda himself, and even though he looks like he's pretty, you know, just kind of limping along with his cane, as soon as he gets a lightsaber in his hand, he is a force to be reckoned with. Alright, now instead of using the force to throw objects back onto him, what you're going to do is he's going to trap one of your players or characters in a lightning strike. Then what you need to do, I just wanted to demonstrate that quickly. So he's going to trap you in a lightning strike, switch to the other character, and then go up to him very quickly and use a saber strike while he's distracted. and then you just want to rinse and repeat this a couple times before he gets sick of you. You can't step inside his force field or else he will just push you away. Stand outside of it, let yourself get caught in lightning strike, switch to the other character, and saber strike him down because he has the ultimate tunnel vision and will not do a darn thing to stop you. So just rinse and repeat this until he's had just about enough of it. At which point he goes back to standard combat, and then here you can just saber strike him to death. It's a pretty easy boss fight to beat. If I don't miss my saber strikes, which I seem to be doing pretty consistently. Okay, here we go. Attack of the Clones, done. Level complete, free play unlocked. Episode 2 complete, super story unlocked. Today we unlocked the Master Yoda himself. We of course earned True Jedi and raised our total stud count by that value and obtained 3 mini-kits. We also got some gold bricks, one for completing the level, and another for earning True Jedi. And that is it for this episode. So, thanks for watching, stay tuned for next time, and I hope to catch you all on Tuesday for some more LEGO Star Wars Complete Saga. Goodbye, and enjoy the final cutscene, and the credits. Ha ha ha.